Welcome inside our NBA studio with Chauncey, Jalen, and Paul. I'm Michelle. Tonight's Going Places is brought to you by Toyota. Woo! Chauncey, I'm going to start with you.
I've been very impressed with Ben Simmons. I thought he was going to be playing point forward. He's actually playing point guard. He's bringing the ball up. They're outletting it to him. Sneaks in the paint right there for an easy bucket. But look at him right here coming off the pick and roll. Has that great vision. Catches John Wall sleeping. Got a shooter in the corner. That's a point guard play. And I really thought that it was going to be a LeBron-type situation where he's really playing small forward, but he's getting the handle. No, they're outletting the ball to him. They're setting up the plays with him. I've been very impressed with Ben Simmons.
And I'm glad you did the distinction because so many guys his size were drafted out of college. Magic Johnson, Steve Smith, Penny Hardaway.
Jalen Rose.
Thank you, sir. There were 6'7"-plus point guards. And then when they talk about can they play, make the transition, is are they guarding the other team's point guard?
Yes.
And tonight, that's John Wall. He's 3-for-13 in the first half. One of the top players we have going in the game. He's doing a good job of keeping the perimeter oriented. That's going to be a big-time task to see if he can do it the entire game.
While he's looking good, I mean, he's getting to the hole. He's coming off the pick and roll. My biggest question on him is, can he shoot the jumper? Why hasn't anybody went under the pick and roll? Why aren't you backing up? His size alone should just tell you, I need to back up. This guy's too big. If he gets a step, he's going to finish at the rim. But I'm impressed with what I saw so far.
The elephant in the room is obviously Joel Embiid and his minutes limitation. We talked about before the game, 16 to 20 is where they're shooting. Embiid's response to the restriction, you can see that right there.
He only has 7 minutes left.
He said 13-02. And that's if they go on the high end.
7 minutes left, big fella.
So somewhere between 3 and 7 minutes left in the second half.
So we've seen the last of Joel Embiid tonight is what we're saying?
I don't know.
He played a great game tonight, I'm telling you.
That last 7 minutes of the third quarter, and then he's out of there.
No question. No crunch time, playing buddy. The game, I appreciate it. He waited till he got his big deal to convert to cornrows.
You really
good
you
job
really
playing
just
corporate
feel that
America.
In your heart, huh?
Facts on facts.
You call him anything.
Is the ink dry? Okay, cool. Braid it on down.
That's how it works. It's a conscious effort on his part. All kidding aside, if they bring him out to just start off the second half and it does become one of those crunch time situations, can you break the restriction? I mean, I feel like you're painting yourself into a corner by doing this.
You find out something very quickly. If they break the restriction, they're saying, you know what? We're trying to win this season.
13 period. Minutes.
No matter what.
11.6 rebounds. Imagine if he was playing 35 minutes. This guy's on pace for, 30 and 15? I mean, don't hold this back. We trusted the process for 4 years. Let's
keep trusting the process.
But also, when you're a terrific talent like him and your minutes are limited, they tend to feed you the ball, so that helps his per 36 numbers. But ultimately, if they're going to be a playoff team, he's got to play more than 20 minutes tonight.
I'm hoping that happens soon. Texas native Jimmy Butler has arrived at the AT&T Center for the second game of a doubleheader between the Wolves and the Spurs. Jalen, big debut for Mr. Butler.
What is that, a Christmas ornament or something?
Absolutely, I do.
It is sparkly.
Taught me that he drives a minivan.
Oh.
I can't relate.